Ciao friends! In this video, I want to solve one calculation that typically happens when you're doing budgeting. I am not going to talk about budgeting a lot, because if you are interested in budgeting, we have a pattern on daxpattern.com that goes much deeper than I will ever be able to do in a short YouTube video. Instead, I want to focus on one calculation. That happens whenever you need to plot in the same chart the actuals and the forecast. This is challenging because actuals and forecast, they do have different timelines. The actuals typically stop at some point, today, because you don't have sales after today, whereas forecasts are available for the entire year. Therefore, plotting them together in a chart or showing them in a matrix is challenging because you need to pay attention to the dates in order to provide meaningful results. Let's start by looking together at the scenario. I prepared a report, and here sales stop on the 15th of August. You see that after August, the value of sales amount shows a blank. Actually, they end on the 15th of August. And I have the forecast for this year. Forecast, of course, starts on the 1st of January, and I also have forecast for the future. I typically want to compute the year-to-date of sales and the year-to-date of forecast, and that is what I computed here through two simple year-to-date calculations. Year-to-date of sales amount at some point shows the same value again and again, whereas the forecast goes on because there are values available also for the future. Now, this proves to be a problem whenever, instead of using a matrix, you plot data on a chart, because the forecast still provides a good line, whereas the sales amount is just ugly to look at. You see what happens? This is the value of the year-to-date of sales amount that reaches the 15th of August, and then it becomes a flat line, because it does no longer grow. On the other hand, the year-to-date of the forecast grows also in the future, because we do have data for the future. What I would like to obtain is a different visualization. I would like to create a chart like this, where I have combined in this first line both the sales and the forecast. I'm showing the actuals up to today, and then I'm extending the line with the value of the forecast. So this line that becomes flat is the year-to-date of the sales amount. The red dotted line is the combined calculation, and the black dotted line is still the forecast. You will typically hide this line because it's not interested. I still have it here because you see that already in August, the two values are split, because sales stop on the 15th of August, and therefore already for the month of August, the two values are different. How do I compute such a value? Well, in order to compute it, what I need is to be able to compute the remaining forecast that you can see here. This is the same report as before, but now I have the sales amount, the forecast as earlier, but I have another measure, remaining forecast. Remaining forecast computes the value of the forecast for the future. So it only computes the forecast for dates after today. And the thing is, what do we mean by today? Today is the last date for which we have sales. So in order to compute this number, we will need to compute the last date for which we have sales, and then compute the value of the forecast only for the future. The interesting part is that I can now add the two values together and build the sales and forecast measure that computes the actuals up to the point where we have sales. Already in August, you see that this number is different than the forecast, and it's different than the sales amount, because it already combines together forecast and actuals, whereas in the future, it only shows the forecast. So our goal will be computing the remaining forecast. All the remaining part of the calculation are absolutely simple to do, and if you are interested in looking at more details, you can go to SQL BI, download the article, and there you will find the file. So we need to compute this remaining forecast, and we start with this model where I already have the remaining forecast, but we are going to rewrite it together in order to understand step by step how it works. Now, the first thing that we need to do is compute the last date for which we have sales. Once we have this last date, then we will compute the forecast after that date. And finally, we will be able to combine everything together. We already have the solution, but I'm going to write a new one. So let's start with a new measure. We call it RF, remaining forecast. And we first need a variable, which is the last date with sales. This can be as simple as max of sales order date. Let's start returning the temporary values that we compute. So we do that step by step, and we are sure that there are no problems in the calculation. So let's just compute the last date with sales and see how lucky we are with that. But as you see, it is not correct. It is showing the 29th of January in January, the 28th of February, the 31st of March in March. Sometimes it's the end of the month, sometimes it's a bit earlier than the end of the month. And the reason is, when I compute this max, that is happening in the filter context defined by the matrix that contains January, February, or March. I need to get rid of that filter context to obtain the last date ever. So that needs to become calculate max of sales order date, and I can just use remove filters if I want to get rid of any filter from the model, or remove filters from the date if I only want to get rid of the filter from the date. Computing it this way, now you see it returns the 15th of August everywhere. So now that I have the date, the last date with sales, I need to compute the forecast after that date. Again, I need another calculator. Let's call it remaining forecast. And that can be calculate the value of the forecast. And then I apply a filter on the date that need to be greater or equal the last date with sales. If I did it correctly, this will produce the forecast only after the last date. Let's return this as the result. It's not going to work, but it's useful to see why it doesn't work. I want to reduce that a bit. So let me go back a bit, and then we look at the code. You see, it returns the same value everywhere, 27708. Why is it doing that? The reason is that this condition, date greater than last date with sales, overrides the filter context on the date. And because date is marked as a date table, it kills any filter on the table and replaces it with this new filter. What I want to do is combine this filter with the outer one. So I want to keep the filter on April 2010 and add this further filter. That's why I need to keep filters around it. And if I use keep filter, now I have my calculation. You see that it shows a blank everywhere up to July, but starting from August, it shows a value. Now, going further, it's only a matter of summing this value with the forecast, and with that, you will be able to build the chart exactly as it is, where I'm showing the year-to-date of the sales amount combined with the forecast, or just the year-to-date of the sales amount. It is a simple calculation that only requires basic understanding of calculate and the filter context. As you have seen, once you have a solid understanding of how the filter context works, computing this calculation is straightforward. Now, if you are interested in looking in more details, go to sqlbi.com. There you will find the article, and you will be able to download the file and play with it. Just pay attention that the file contains some advanced DAX code, which is not explained in the article. But if you want to understand more details about how that code is computed on DAX pattern, you will find a complete explanation on how to build budgets with Power BI. Enjoy DAX!